Mickey Benassus in the corner.
First round, time, fight!
Round one!
One then. Quick knees for heavyweight, you know, fast hands. Not come intimidated, Aissa. Both scoring, nice sharp technique, just leaves his chin a little bit too high. Aissa, they get caught here, and he got caught low. Nidal seems, watch how he, when Nidal gets close, he lifts his chin up in the air. Aissa, and that doesn't bode well, I tell you,
fight.
With this kid.
Fight.
Especially with the corner they've got of Siam Jim's master himself, Mickey Benassus. Ooh, that was a big shot, I said that. Right behind the ear, he's got to stay down because that'll take the equilibrium away.
Five, six.
That was a good shot right behind the back of the head. Fighting spirit of Bchiri will come out. Slung his own right hand over the top, Bchiri. Exchanging good shots already. High kick just over the head, and trying that right hand again. Aissa, nice scoring shots from Nidal, but he's behind now, isn't he, with that 10-8 round. And was it useful, this Aissa, though? But he sticks his chin up a little bit when he gets, but he's starting to put that down now. But Bchiri's got it. Fine. The shot caught again there, you know. Bustle to the floor. Oh, that was nice. Just missed the knee, though, of Aissa, who's impressed me. Because Nidal's a good fighter. Buzz around Belgrade about this show. Heavy left kick has been immense, and to get to fight on Abu Dhabi is an absolute treat for any fighter in the world, let me tell you. Caught there, Aissa. Interesting round that was. He did well to get up from that. The equilibrium was gone. Punched behind the ear by the Frenchman. You can see that knockdown again. The concussive shot, but it was behind the ear that does discombobulate and put him down. There you go, chopping right hand, and his legs slip from underneath him. Quite smart, though, of what he did. Is he didn't jump up straight away. There you go then, it's a good shot, but he started to come through with his own shots. Nidal as well, caught again there, nice left kick to the body. Bchiri, he's got it all to do. Well, this could be an upset with the little known, very well known quantity to us, the Frenchman, Boualem. We'll see.
Round two then.
Big long right hand from Bchiri. Going for it now, isn't he? He got caught again there, you know, that right hand, that short sweep. at all, Aissa. Caught again, Bchiri. A good knee, left knee from Aissa. Oh, there you go. Something's happened with the Frenchman's arm. I think his shoulder's dislocated. Or is it something happened with his arm then? They've got a count each now. Something's definitely happened to his arm. He can't keep it up. Yeah, I think he's broke his hand, you know. I think he's broke his hand. There's something going on with the right side. Look how he's just using his left. Through the right before. Yeah, something going on here. He broke his hand or there's something going on with his shoulder, but brave, brave guy here, this Aissa Boualem. But again, I think he's broke his hand. Or his arm. Something's going on. Yeah, he's in real bad pain. Oh, you can stop it, ref. Yeah, it should stop it, and I think something's gone wrong, terribly wrong with his arm, and you know what? That's a massive shame, because he was really, really doing his best. You know, we don't like to see that. I think he broke his hand, or his wrist, or whatever, on the iron head of the Moroccan, who did so well. He's got to give credit to Bchiri, who stayed in there and did well. Boualem, great work by our OB van and our camera people here to get us that. Look at that.
Ladies and gentlemen, at 1:48 of the second round, Aissa Boualem retires with an injury, declaring our winner by way of TKO and moving on to our heavyweight tournament final later in the evening. Nidal Bchiri!
Oh, what a great shame that was. You know what? Made me feel a bit flat, that ladies and gentlemen, but never mind, this will cheer me up. Coming up is absolutely more monsters of kickboxing. Don't you go away here on Enfusion.